Hi, this is the second part of this series, and this time I want to talk about Sente moves. And in the previous part, we found a formula to count values of moves in the endgame. So this was the formula: the value of move is the number of points gained with the first move plus half the value of the continuation. And now let's look if this formula is really universal. Here we have an example. So what happens here? If black plays a move, then this will be his privilege, and he has 4 points here and white has 0. And then we look at what happens if white plays and black answers. Then white already gained this 1 point and black doesn't have these 2, so it is 3 points difference. And then we look at the value of the continuation divided by 2. So what is the continuation? Here white kills this whole group, and this is very big, like 18 points, I don't know. So this would mean that this move is very big, like 12 points, but this sounds a bit much and counterintuitive. So what is wrong? So maybe instead of trying to figure what is the value of this move, first let's answer maybe easier question. How many points right now black has here in this corner? So our old method would tell us to first look at the first stage of the situation. Here black has 4 points and white has 0 points. Then this would be the second stage where we don't know. And the third stage would be this one. So black has only 1 point because either he plays and he has 2 or white plays. And then white has 1 plus 18 or 16 divided by 2. So a lot. How is it in total, like in the second stage, how many points? Well, it appears that in the second stage, white should have more points in this corner than black, but this is for sure incorrect. So where is the problem? The problem is that we were looking at this continuation of white, but this continuation will never happen in the actual game. So in practice, when white plays this move, black will just answer, and then black will never let white kill this whole corner. So if we try to answer how many points black has in this corner right now, we should imagine this being this way. So currently, in fact, black has 2 points in this corner and white has 1 point here. And now we can maybe figure what is the value of this Sente move, or of maybe rather of playing here for black, because for white it is Sente, but we know that often in games it would happen that white would be busy playing in different locations and then he would finish in Gothe, and then black needs to know if it's a good time to descend here, if it's big enough. So let's take a look at another situation. Here we know what happens. After black plays, he has 6 points, and if white connects, then black would have 0 points. So we say that currently black has 3 points here. And then when black plays, he has 6 points. So he improves his current situation by 3 points. And now we can see that a similar thing happens here. Right now, we say that black locally has 2 points and white has 1 point. But if black got to play here, then he has 4 points and white has 0. So black improved his local situation by 3 points. So now we can see that this move is equivalent to that move. It is as good to play 3 points in reverse center as play 6 points. Okay, and this leads us to a formula for Sente moves. So playing a Sente move is worth twice as much as the points gained with the first move. And maybe this argument was a bit confusing for you, and maybe it's still a bit unclear. So let's see if it works in practice. Here we have two situations where white's move is 3 points in Sente. And here we have 6 points in Gothe. Let's see if these are really equivalent. So first, let's look at this variation. Black takes these 3 stones, and white gets these Hane connections in Sente. Now, it is white's turn. White finished in Sente, and these are the borders of territories. And then our second variation would be black choosing these 3 points in reverse Sente, white connecting the stone, and black playing this. Now, it is again white's turn. White finished in Sente, and then black moved the borders of the territories here like this. So he gained 6 points here, but instead he didn't capture these three stones. So we can see that in fact these situations are really equivalent, which means that Sente move is really equal to twice as big move but in Gotte. And then let's answer the very important question. What counts as a Sente move? So here we have three examples. This move for black would be 5 points, we think, in Sente, because the continuation is very big. And we already said that black shouldn't play this move if there is an 11 points move somewhere on the board, because then that 11 points move would be bigger. But if the biggest move on the board is anyway only 10 points or smaller, then it's already fine for black to play here. And for reference, here we have a move which is worth 10 points in Gotte, connecting these 5 stones. So if black plays here, then we need to think if the continuation is bigger than 10 points. And it is, because taking these 7 stones is like 14 points. And then this is only 10 points. So if the continuation is bigger than twice the value of the first move, then black can be sure that white will play here. Black knows that there are no bigger moves on the board, because otherwise he would choose those moves. So if the continuation is at least twice as big as the first move, then this move counts as Sente. And here we have another example. If black plays this move, he already takes 5 points. And then the continuation is how big? It is 7 points. It is big, but if there are moves like 9 points on the board, on 10 points, then white will not answer. So this doesn't count as Sente. So now, once we know that a Sente move is a move with a continuation twice as big as the first move, we can finally formulate a final formula for values of moves in the endgame. So a value of move is the number of points gained with the first move, and then the smaller of these two numbers. Value of the continuation divided by 2, or once again, the points gained with the first move. So this would apply for Sente moves, and this would apply for Gotte moves. And now that we have this formula, let's just take a look at some simple examples. Here, this move, is it Sente? So now we can really see that a Sente in the endgame is a local term, because if there are 10 points moves at the board, then for sure white will not answer this move. But black can wait with this move to the point where there are no bigger moves, and then it will be his privilege, because if white doesn't answer, then the continuation is, in fact, 1, 2, 3, 4 points. So to this move, white will answer. So this move is worth 1 point in Sente. And then what is with this one? This push. When white pushes, how big is the continuation? Well, the continuation is 1 point in Sente. If white plays here, then black will need to answer. So the continuation is 1 point in Sente or 2 points. We already know that these are equivalent. So this is a 1 point move with 2 points move continuation, so it can be counted as Sente. So regardless if it is counted as Sente or a Gotte with a continuation of 2 moves, it would be 2 points move. Here we have a very common shape. How big is it to capture these 2 stones? Well, it's important to be able to count it. So if black played first, no one has any points. But if white played and black answered, then already white gained 1 point, because white captured 2 stones and black captured only 1 stone. And then we need to count the value of the continuation. So if black doesn't answer, then with connecting the stone, white saves the stone and takes this 1 point of territory. So it is worth 2 points. So again, this move, taking these 2 stones, is a 1 point move with a 2 points continuation. So here we can either count it as 2 points in Gotte or count it as 1 point in Sente. Anyway, it is equivalent to 2 points. And then this is our last example. What happens here? If Black plays himself, then how big is the continuation? Well, the continuation is just 1 point. So this move cannot be counted as Sente. White doesn't need to answer here. And then what would be if White had a longer cave to go for Black here? Next move of Black is worth less than 2 points because it is not 1 point in Sente. It is, in fact, 1.5. Then this point also cannot be counted as Sente. But it is, in fact, almost 2 points. It is 1.34. And then, once Black would have a stone here, so somewhere far there is this 2 points move, then already this move can be counted as 2 points. Because then the continuation is also worth 2 points, because the continuation is also 2 points. So this move is 1 point in Sente or 2 points in Gote. Okay, I hope this was all clear, and thank you for listening to the second part of this series.